Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Monday, the feast of Saints Pedro Bautista, Paul Mickey, and companions. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Holy men shed their glorious blood for the Lord. They loved Christ in their life. They imitated him in their death, and therefore were crowned in triumph.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, strength of all the saints, who through the cross were pleased to call the martyrs, Saints Pedro Bautista, Paul Mickey, and companions, to life, grant, we pray, that by their intercession, we may hold with courage even until death to the faith that we profess. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw how good the light was. God then separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. Thus evening came, and morning followed, the first day. Then God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters, to separate one body of water from the other." And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came and morning followed, the second day. Then God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into a single basin, so that the dry land may appear." And so it happened. The water under the sky was gathered into its basin, and the dry land appeared. God called the dry land the earth, and the basin of the water he called the sea. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth vegetation, every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on the earth that bears fruit with its seed in it." And so it happened. The earth brought forth every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the third day. Then God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night. Let them mark the fixed times, the days and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth." And so it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day, the lesser one to convert the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky, to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came and morning followed, the fourth day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. May the Lord be glad in his works.
May the Lord be glad in his works.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. You are clothed with majesty and glory, robed in light as with a cloak.
May the Lord be glad in his works.
You fixed the earth upon its foundation, not to be moved forever. With the ocean as a garment, you covered it. Above the mountains, the waters stood.
May the Lord be glad in his works.
You send forth springs into the watercourses that wind among the mountains. Beside them, the birds of heaven dwell. From among the branches, they send forth their song.
May the Lord be glad in his works.
How manifold are your works, O Lord! In wisdom you have wrought them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Alleluia.
May the Lord be glad in his works.
Alleluia, alleluia. Jesus preached the gospel of the kingdom and cured every disease among the people. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After making the crossing to the other side of the sea, Jesus and his disciples came to land at Gennesaret and tied up there. As they were leaving the boat, people immediately recognized him. They scurried about the surrounding country and began to bring in the sick on mats to wherever they heard he was. Whatever villages or towns or countryside he entered, they laid the sick in the marketplaces and begged him that they might touch only the tassel of his cloak. And as many as touched it were healed. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now, when you take a look at this gospel, you realize how popular the Lord was, no? How much he's preaching, and most especially his healing, no? And then even his exorcising evil spirits, how much that made him very, very popular, as you see in the gospel as it is described, no? It was wherever people found out that he was present, people would just come and bring their sick relatives and friends, no, for him to touch and to heal. So, you know, when you read something like this, no, I cannot help but think of the definition of vocation or mission that we would always refer to. It is where our deep gladness meets a deep hunger of the world. And that's the first point that I invite you to reflect on, no? To see that the Lord was responding for a very deep hunger of his time. That is the hunger for healing. That first point to reflect on, no? And then the second point is that when you also hear this gospel like this, no, and then also in the other gospels a few days back, remember we read the gospel wherein the Lord brought his disciples after they went on mission. He brought them to a deserted place in order to rest. But then people started to come, no, and then here you have everywhere Christ went, people demanded from him, no. And demanded that they be healed, that he hold, no, healing sessions, no. That second point that I invite you to reflect on is the price of our commitments, no. And again, if you recall, in John 21, the last resurrection appearance in the Gospel of John, the Lord tells Peter, no, when you were younger, you went about as you please, but as you grow older, you will hold out your hand, and another will tie you fast and carry you off against your will. And I'd like to invite you to reflect on the price of commitment, no? And the third and final point is here, you know, in many healing stories, you know, there's that element of touch. I don't know if you noticed that, no? Like here it says that people were saying if only they could touch the tassel of his cloak. And the same with the woman with hemorrhages, no? And of course, even the Lord, when he would heal people, he would touch them, no? So here I'd like to reflect as a third and final point for a reflection is the whole element of touch, no, in the ministry of healing, especially in the ministry of the Lord. Siguro itong tatlong punto to ng pagnilaya natin sa Ebanghelyo ngayon na makita natin dito yung uhaw ng mga tao. At yun ang una natin pagninilayan. Di ba ngayon sabi natin yung definition ng bukasyon or mission ay kung saan nagtatagpo ang uhaw ng tao, ang gutom ng tao sa ating malalim na kagalakan. Yun ang unang punto ng pagninilay. At yung pangalawang punto ng ating pagninilay, ay makikita natin na merong buwis, sabi nga natin, may buwis, there is a price, may buwis ang ating mga commitments, ang ating pagiging alagad ng Diyos, no? At yung pangatlo, tuling punto, ay nais ko rin pagnilayan natin yung makikita natin sa maraming kwento ng paghilom, yung touch o yung paghipo ng Panginoon sa mga may sakit. At yung sinasabi nga ng mga tao, di ba, sa Ebanghelyo ngayon, mahawakan ko lang, mahipo ko lamang yung kanyang, yung laylayan ng kanyang damit, gagaling na ako. First, about the deep hunger and the deep gladness of the world, you realize that even to this day that continues. Well, yes, what I invite you to reflect on is that what is it that you have somehow discerned as God's mission for you, as God's call for you, no? And try to ask yourself, with what God is asking of me, what is the deep hunger of people around me that I am responding to? Because I think that's very, very true, no? The meeting point between our deep gladness and the deep hunger of the world, that is where God is calling us to. Now, when you realize that, you realize that our faith is a faith of joy. It doesn't mean that we are struggle-free or problem-free, but our faith is a faith of joy precisely because our joy of serving and to respond to a deep hunger of the world, that is the source of our sense of mission. No? And therefore, fundamentally, our deep gladness, our deepest joy in the things that we do, meeting a deep hunger of the world as our vocation, again, tells us, no, that our faith is a faith of joy. And that joy comes when we serve, when we live out our vocation and mission. Siguro yung unang punto niya, nakikita natin yan sa kwento ng Panginoon, na siya ay bukas palad at buong-buong puso na laging tumutugon sa pangangailangan ng tao. Yan ang kahulugan ng pagiging alagad ng Panginoon, na ang ating buhay ay napupuno ng kagalakan dahil nga tayo ay naglilingkod. And the second point is, again, the commitments that we have. That when everything is said and done, of course, we have a vocation, we have a call, we have a mission. But ultimately, all of these have meaning because we are committed to it. We commit ourselves to this call. We commit ourselves to this vocation. And as we would like to reflect on and to reflect on our commitments, that part of the price and at the same time the grace of commitment is that it will carry us off against our will. In other words, in a sense, we have no total control of our life because we surrender our life to that commitment. And yet, that is the greatest freedom. The greatest freedom is not that we do anything that we want. No, that is not freedom. That, yes, we are free to do things. But the greatest freedom is when we are able to commit ourselves to something greater than ourselves, especially to God's call for us. And there is a price for that, no? We give up things, we sacrifice, and yet I think what really inspires us is that, again, we have offered this to God. The commitment has a price. Siguro mahalagang makita rin natin yun, na merong masasabi natin na meron tayong buwis, eka nga, sa ating mga pagtatalaga ng sarili, na meron niya ang hinihingi sa atin. Pero bahagi yan ng ating kagalakan dahil yan ay ating pagtatalaga ng sarili at alam natin na ito ang hinihingi sa atin ng pagkakataon, itong tawag ng ating mga pagtatalaga. So that second point to reflect on, no, that our commitments is what will lead our lives, but that it will bring us to where God wants us to do. And then the third and final point is the whole element of touch. You know, I just invite you to reflect on one point, no, with this element of touch in many healing stories. You know, it's a very physical phenomenon, no? Christ touching the sick person desiring to touch even just the clothes of Christ to be healed. You know, and I think there in that moment of the phenomenon of touch, it is the divine meeting the human faith, the human compassion, the human faith meeting the compassion of God. And I think that is such a beautiful image, you know, that every time the Lord touches someone to heal him or her, it is the deepest desire of the human heart to be healed that meets the deepest love and mercy of God, the divine love meeting the human hunger and need. That is where the meeting point of that is the touch. Siguro mahalagang makita natin yung napakagandang kahulugan, no, nung paghawak ng Diyos sa mga may sakit. Yung paghawak ng mga tao sa damit ng Diyos na buong-buong pananalig na sila ay gagaling. saan nagtatagpo ang banal na pag-unawa sa atin, ang banal na pagmamahal at pagkalinga ng Diyos at ang pinakamalalim na hangarin ng tao. So today, let us reflect on this gospel and let us reflect on how this continues on in our world today. The hungers of people and the commitments that we will make and the commitments that will lead us to where God wants us to go. And then the third and final point is always to remember that whenever we bring about the presence of Christ, the ability or that possibility to touch where the human desires and hopes meet the divine love, then that is where we bring Christ. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray to the Father who wants everyone to be healed. He does not reject those who come to Him in need.
That as a church, we may not close our hearts to the needs of others, but share God's love with everyone. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may all work for justice and human dignity, especially for those who are left out by society, including the weak and the poor. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we as a community may support and uplift one another with the love and gentleness which the Lord has shown us. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive, Holy Father, the offerings we bring in commemoration of the holy martyrs, and grant that we, your servants, may be found steadfast in confessing your name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyrs poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people, your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saints Pedro Bautista, Paul Mickey and companions, the martyrs, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. Together now, let us offer our prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly served and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build a world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago, and to which succeeding generations offer their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes, also Filipinos, may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. O God, who in your holy martyrs have wonderfully made known the mystery of the cross, graciously grant that drawing strength from this sacrifice, we may cling faithfully to Christ and labor in the church for the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. Have a good day ahead and have a good week ahead. Thank you po.
In 2022, we received more than 60 million pesos worth of donations from you. Hindi po matatawaran ang tulong at suporta na inyong ibinigay upang tayo sa Caritas Philippines ay makapagbahagi din ng tulong sa mga pamilyang nasalanta ng bagyo, iginupo ng lindol, mga nasadlak sa baha at patuloy na nahihirapan dahil sa COVID-19 pandemic. We also utilized your donations to send children to school, feed families, provide livelihood and food security, advocate for justice, help in peace building, and protect our environment better. Tunay ngang kapag patuloy ang ating pagmamalasakit, pagbabahagi, at pag-aalay kapwa, mas maraming Pilipino ang gumagaan ang buhay.
Tandaan po natin, sa pag-aalay kapwa, may pag-asa ang bagong taon.